I'm trying to see if I can. Here she goes, right here. Yes. Yes, let me show you her picture. Some of you all may know who this is right here. Yes. Ladies and gentlemen, without any further ado, are y'all ready for the next poetess?
Can she flow?
Y'all already know, put your hands together for Johnny Q.
I was in love with ecstasy once. He courted me under sunsets while we picnicked in a field of flowers. Sipped Riesling from Germany while I fell into the sweet vapors of stargaze lilies in a handcrafted vase of my favorite color. Oh, ecstasy was crafty. I craved him constantly. Not only did he make love to my body, he stroked my ego and my intellect simultaneously. Wrapped his existence around my being, and I wasn't resistant. I needed him for my sunrises and sets. I couldn't breathe without him. I became Pinocchio to his Geppetto. No strings attached, yet evident I was no longer in control. How fatuous of me to assume any other genuine, because I'd seen the warning signs, yet I was speeding towards fairy tales, evil twins. Complacency and cowardness. Who knew that his romantic silence would turn into hateful affirmations at an octave to crack glass? My sunrise eclipsed by the smashing of my lips and the thrashing between my hips, the killing of my spirit was at play. It was time for an instant replay of reasons I needed to flee. I needed to flee to save me, because this infection called ecstasy ran all through me. And there wasn't anything left but misery. Upon my reasonable request for him to set me free, he wooed me into submission, helping me to forget that he was my lethal addiction. Ecstasy ran through my veins, killing me softly, eating me lovely, enticing my freedom to live with him forever. I was stuck. So upon his slumber, I fell to my knees and I began to pray. I prayed for strength, wisdom, and self-assurance, because I lacked the endurance to stay. Ecstasy awoke, and he wasn't pleased with the peace that lit up my soul when he birthed darkness. His rants violent as he charged towards me, reached out and iced me, ripped my hair out as he sodomized me, and bang, bang was his fist to my lips, and bang, bang was his thrust between my hips, and bang, bang was my head against the nightstand, and bang, bang, my pistol rang. Bang, bang, the door caved in, but it was too late for ecstasy. You see, I had finally been set free. Sky red as a blunt, or does my smirk danced in the darkness? Had I really been set free? I had an icebox where my heart used to be. Oh, ecstasy was crafty, you see. He planted a seed that lived on in me. I craved him constantly. I yearned the smashing of my lips and the thrashing between my hips. The killing of my spirit was successful. Because even in killing him, I was a bit remorseful, so I had to check into spiritual rehab. I prayed and fasted for 6 days. One day for each year ecstasy stole from me. I was reaching a new version of me. God lived here now. And he slayed all demons who constructed plots to infect my mind, my body, and my soul. He made me whole. And that's my peace.